She keeps reminding me that you're still gone and I'm still lonely.
He keeps reminding me how good it was
when we were.
There it is, Sean Hook and Reminding Me with Vanessa Hudgens. I just said that is a sexy video. And I asked you, Sean, do you only do sexy videos?
It's in the clause.
It's in the
clause. Only sexy videos.
Almost every single one of them is sexy.
Listen, thank you so much for...
Well, you're a sexy man.
You are.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us, by the way. Big congratulations. We were just told 22 million streams now of Reminding Me. So what goes through your head? Does it just burst? What happened?
No, it's unfathomable. You know, it's before I put a song out, it's exciting, but it's also, there's a lot of anxiety. So I'm not sure how people are going to react to the music, but when I hear that number and I see that fans are reacting, it just adds affirmation to I'm doing something right.
Do you stand in front of the mirror and smile?
No, not at all. No.
I did listening to the song. How did the collaboration come to be with Vanessa?
So Vanessa and I kind of live in the same area in LA, and we have a lot of mutual friends. And when it came time to find a feature for the record, I reached out to them and they got to Vanessa. I met her for coffee and kind of went from there.
Well, your voices go beautifully together.
Thank you so much.
Honestly, it's what a great song. Let's talk about the album as well. The album's called My Side of the Story, just released. How would you describe this album compared to previous
ones? What is your side of the story? What story are we talking about?
I know.
It's called My Side of Your Story. It's kind of a play on words. There's only 4 songs in the EP, and it's 4 songs from about 80 songs I had written in the last year and a half.
80, wow.
About 80, yeah.
Wow.
And when it came to titling the record, I tried to find the common thread of this record.
Okay.
And a lot of these songs have to deal with adversity and relationships, and the songs are narratives, and hence the title, My Side of Your Story.
Your story.
So obviously this video was shot in your home.
Yeah, right.
But honestly, listen, you're a Canadian.
The dream home.
And you just, the dream home.
Yeah, the dream home. So you live out there now.
Yeah, I'm back and forth still.
Back and forth. Yeah. And you're saying that this album talks a lot about relationships, adversities. Yeah. Is it hard to find love in LA? And especially now that you're a known guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, LA is a tough city to find love. I mean, there's a lot of people that move there to make it. And you know, sometimes they don't have the best intentions in mind. A lot of people move on to bigger, better things, and relationships are hard to maintain. But
is it hard to know who to trust over there?
It is. It is. When I first moved down, though, I met a lot of great people in Los Angeles outside of the industry that I still call my friends and consider family.
I want to, not everybody at home may realize how multi-talented you are, because you, listen, you play how many instruments now?
Well, I started playing piano, and then I moved to guitar, and then I played trombone for a bit.
Where did the trombone come from?
That's an interesting choice.
Yeah, well,
the ladies love the trombone.
It wasn't really a choice. It kind of was, I think.
They like a good horn.
Okay, good morning.
I'm just throwing it out there.
I got assigned the trombone in high school. It was like,
oh, did you?
Yeah, okay. I chose the drums, the saxophone, and then I put trombone at the very end. And that's what I was given to learn. But I excelled in it. I joined a cover band after high school. And
you
really
were in a disco
it.
Cover band,
Disco cover
you?
Band, yeah. We toured all around
BC. I love
BC.
It, though. You remember we used to make fun of disco? Now everyone loves it, right? Because it just brings out the best in
people. And it was my first paid gig as a musician, was a trombone player. I was like, wow, I'm making money playing the trombone.
So when you look at the success that you have, I mean, we were just talking at the start of the show, it's such a great moment for Canadian musicians in all different genres. I mean, Justin Bieber, Drake, The Weeknd, the list goes on and on. Do you think that this is a moment for Canadians right now, or is it just that the world is finally starting to notice the talent that we have, or a combination?
I think it's a combination, and it's funny, I've spent a lot of time in the U.S. going to different radio stations, and it's become apparent outside of Canada that everyone's like, what's going on in Canada? What's in the water? What are you guys doing with your talent up there? But I think it has to do with what our government does for our artists.
That's a good point.
There's a lot of support for the arts with Factor. There's also CanCon for our radio stations. Mm-hmm. And so I feel like that at the early stages helps us have a platform to get our music out there.
Who do you listen to? Who's on your...
I'm all over the
iPod,
map.
Man. I just almost dated myself. Does
Who's
anyone
on your Walkman?
Who's on your Sony Walkman or Discman?
My first Sony Walkman tapes were CNC Music Factory.
Oh, yes.
I love CNC.
MC Hammer, Vanilla Ice, and Michael Jackson Bad. Those tapes got me through kindergarten.
You know, Vanilla Ice, many make fun of him, but many are inspired by Vanilla Ice. So it's good that you...
I love that tune. Listen, everyone likes that tune. You have to admit it.
But let's talk about who you would want to work with now, because the doors are open, right? So things must be a lot easier. I've heard that Sia's on the list.
Yeah, I love Sia. She's one of the most incredible singers and also a songwriter. She's so prolific. There's a lot of producers out there, like Greg Kirsten, who produces a lot of Sia's stuff. Jeff Basker is a big producer. Major Lazer, DJ Snake, I love their production elements. Julia Michaels is a great songwriter and also an artist now that she's coming out. There's a lot of people.
So there's, but you're feeling that this is much more in your realm? Like that, this is accessible to you now, right?
Yeah. It's great. That's what's been cool about this last EP that I put out. There are four quality songs. I got to co-write with Ryan Tedder from Mama Public, Amar Malik, Jay Cash, Jason Evigan, really big songwriters in the LA community.
Well, and I love that so many musicians and artists collaborate now. You know, it's so beautiful to see.
Yeah.
You know, when you consider all the competition, I want to talk about your world record because you did set
a
Guinness
very
world record
this is so random.
Standing on an exercise ball.
Is there a ball
for, was
back
it more
there?
Than 3 hours? No, we're not going to do it. But
although,
have you got?
Now that you say it.
Yeah, do we have an
cue
exercise ball?
Cue the ball. No, we don't.
But obviously, you stay in shape. I'm sure you're not working out as rigorously as you used to, but are you still working out on a fairly regular basis?
Actually, quite a bit. Yeah, 4 to 5 times a week. It's a little tougher on the road, but I do
on
like
the
a.
Ball?
No,
okay.
Not on the ball.
Not on the ball.
That's crazy talk.
I do a high-intensity workout. I actually posted a video on my Instagram about a pretty funny shot the trainer put on reminding me during one of our workouts. I was like, oh, my God, you're not doing this to me now. But, yeah, I try to stay in shape as much as I can.
Well, listen, we just heard that there's no date yet for Montreal for your next...
Work on that.
We are working on it. There's a date, but it's not confirmed yet.
Okay. Do you promise to come back to the show?
100%.
If
I'm invited.
Yeah, you're invited.
Of course you're invited. Yeah, it's an open-door policy for
there
you.
There may or may not be an exercise ball. We'll have to discuss
this. That is true. We'll discuss it with the production team. Congratulations on all your success.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for joining us, Sean. Really appreciate it.
Appreciate your time.
Hey, we'll be back with more BT coming up right after this. Don't go anywhere.
Can't stop this bleeding. Can't stop believing. I'm missing the sound of your heart beating.